morning, students. I hope you all are fine by the grace of God. Today is Monday and we already have learned about the linear expression. And today our topic is evaluation of linear expression. You already have learned about the linear expression. There are two basic points of linear expression. First is the index of each of the variable in linear expression must be equal to 1. And the second is each of the variable is not multiplied or divided by an other variable. And how we can evaluate the linear expression? To evaluate a linear expression, we have to replace each variable by the given value. Then we have to simplify this. It means that we will have a given value in our question, and then we can put the value in the solution, and then we can solve according to their signs. I will explain the evaluation of linear expression by the following question, which is from exercise 4A, page number 90, question number 2, further question A. Given that x is equal to 6 and y is equal to minus 4, evaluate each of the following expressions. Here we have a linear expression which is 4x minus 7y. By putting the value of x is equal to 6 and y is equal to minus 4. Here we have 4 into 6 minus 7 into minus 4. If we multiply these values, like 6 into 4, then we have 24, and 7 into 4, then we get 28. And you already have known about that if we multiply the negative sign, then we get the positive answer, like this. And if we multiply the positive sign, then we have to add the values, and if we add 24 plus 28, then we get 52 with the positive sign. But there is no need to mention the positive sign over here. Here is another example. 2x squared minus y cubed. By putting the value of x is equal to 6 and y is equal to minus 4. Like this. Now we have to take the square of 6. It means that we have to multiply 6 by 2 times, and then we get 36. And the cube of 4, it means that we have to multiply minus 4 thrice, and then we get 4 into 4, then we get plus 16. And if we multiply plus 16 by minus 4, then we get minus 64. Now we have to multiply 36 by 2, then we get 72, and minus into minus, we get the positive answer. So we have to write the 64 over here, and if we add these two numbers, then we get 136 as the answer.